Hello, music lovers, and welcome to another episode of Under the Influence. I know it's been a while since we've been under the influence together, but it's hard to juggle a lot of things all at the same time. Nonetheless, this week has just had the hype train on maximum with Star Wars. You know, after seeing The Mandalorian this week and seeing all the developments in that storyline, I went back and watched the original movies, and I've been kind of watching some of the animated stuff, and it's all so incredibly good, but one of the things that sticks out is the music. Now, the music in Star Wars has influenced me my entire life. Even when I was a child playing bluegrass and I didn't really think about the music, I can always remember those melodies, and I always remember the theme, and like you see Darth Vader on screen, you can have it on mute and still hear the Imperial theme in your head. It's incredible. Talk about that influence this week here in the woodshed. So as everyone probably already knows, John Williams composed all that stuff. I'm not going to try to break any of it down. It's not an instructional video. It's just a celebration of the music. The music was super influential on me when I was young, and now older, making albums and thinking about compositions and melodies, he's one of my biggest influences. Like when I think about the storytelling in his melodies, the way things lift and move and push and pull, the way he uses sometimes a bit more of an unorthodox harmonic approach, like say in Duel of the Fates, where it jumps from that E minor to that C minor. He uses that to kind of build that tension and tell that story. So when I'm writing and I'm making my own records and making my own music, it's not really that I'm trying to play John Williams licks. It's more of just like, can I try to tell a story that way? And can I use that influence of his storytelling musically and incorporate that into my stuff? A lot of times we as guitar players get so caught up in just learning someone's licks and learning technique that we forget about learning about what makes the story, right? What makes a song or a piece of music have a beginning, a middle, and an end? You know what I mean? I think John really was a master of that. And I want to fire off some favorite moments from John Williams' music. Let's hit it. So I think my overall favorite theme is the theme that's in the throne room at the end of Star Wars. And it also ties in a little bit to the Jedi, the Force themes. It's hinted at in the Binary Sunset. And it's just, man, it's iconic. And every time I hear it, it makes me feel good. I go to Disney World, I go to the Star Wars stuff, and I hear it playing on the speakers. I'm just like, yeah, man, I know it. Like, I can see it in my mind. I can see the characters. I'm on the planet. It's like I'm just engulfed in it. And I don't think there's a better theme that connects with me more than the throne room theme. So let's hear that. Another great theme is Leia's theme, and that ties in a little bit to Han and Leia's theme together. If you notice throughout Star Wars, obviously these melodic hooks and these melodic devices that John uses, they reoccur throughout the franchise. So when Han and Leia finally fall in love, there's still those moments that tip the hat to the original Leia's theme, right? So let's take a listen at Leia's theme. It's really pretty. It's a really clever way to start out a theme in D major and wind up in B flat at the end of it. All right, so the prequels. A lot of people love to hate them. A lot of people love them. I think the prequels, for me, I like them better than the newest movies. And some of my favorite moments are in the prequels. And I don't think there is a single musical moment that is more powerful than the Obi-Wan, Darth Maul, Qui-Gon, Duel of the Fates. So let's check out a super metal version of that. Shout out to Ben Eller for throwing some drums and bass on this for me. Great musical moment from the prequels is the Across the Stars theme. That theme, it's all in Attack of the Clones, and it's kind of hidden throughout the entire musical piece that goes with the film. But specifically, right, it's Anakin and Padme anytime they're in love and swooning around or whatever. But I really, really love that theme. Speaking of, there's a young man, Nathan, on YouTube, and I forget his last name. I want to say it's Mills, but he has a beautiful medley, all fingerstyle arrangement stuff. It's so cool. You got to check him out. So I stole a couple of licks or two from his arrangement, and here's the Attack of the Clones Across the Stars theme on acoustic guitar. All right, so if you want to learn any of these arrangements, or you want to learn any of the Star Wars stuff that I've got, or you even want the backing track to Duel of Fates, jump over to Patreon. You can snag it there. Let me know in the comments what your favorite moments from Star Wars music are. I hope you dug this. I can't say enough about John Williams and his impact that he had on me and his music just within Star Wars. I mean, you could talk about all of the John Williams music and all of the catalog that he has, but this is all about Star Wars. And he's just a magical composer that can really tell a story. Thank you, John Williams, for all of the amazing music that you've given us over the years. Star Wars has been an influence on me and it continues to influence me almost every day in so many moments of my music where it's just like, oh, this is where I do the John Williams thing. I should do this with the harmony because that's the John Williams thing. So I think Under the Influence, absolutely. John Williams, you rule.